of Galvino Golf Course. So the idea is I want to really just teach you guys some really simple things. Making cocktails is not a difficult thing whatsoever. And these days, all the bar equipment, all that, all you do is the walk in Williamson or any store in the mall and buy any equipment you need at pretty reasonable prices. And you can definitely do this at home. And what the difference maker that I'm going to teach you is just to use fresh ingredients, because like I was just referring to the food a moment ago about how delicious it is just by using fresh product. Same thing with cocktails. You know, if you have sour mix at home, throw it out. You can make simple syrup at home. Just boil a quart of water and slowly add a quart of sugar to it. Let's stir it up, let it reduce a little bit. Simple syrup that'll last for months for you. You can buy agave syrup, although that has a little more of a distinct flavor. You might not enjoy that in every cocktail you might make. But just by having some simple syrup on hand, using fresh lemons, fresh limes, you can make delicious cocktails. I'm gonna start with a Cosmo there. So you're gonna take your mixing glass, pretty much fill it with ice. And I think the recipe calls for 2 ounces of vodka. I'm gonna use the jigger. Some bartenders talk about count, so it's a 3 count, a 5 count. That's what 2 ounces of vodka in this glass with ice looks like. And then next time you free pour it, and you have that picture in mind, you count yourself 1, 2, 3. Oh, right, by the time I said 3 to myself, I was there. So for me, that's a 3 count. Add 1 ounce of our triple sec, or in this case, Creole Shrub. And I made one before. And those limes are pretty tart, so I'm gonna actually cheat and put a little splash more. I'm gonna take half a lime. And you're gonna want one of these doohickeys, which squeezing a lime and using the smaller one.
Okay.
Oh, I like
cool.
This. Cute.
I love that. Lime.
Just splash your cream
right. I have a feeling we're gonna have like cocktail parties in my house.
I think so. I'll be there Saturday.
I hope so.
Cocktail glass that was well chilled a few minutes ago, and now it's, I talk too much and it's not working. And just a nice, vigorous shake.
How easy is this cream business?
And let the drink not go in the mixing glass, the shaker, because it's bigger. At this point, it's easier to work with. So you could strain it this way, a little practice, or you could simply use the strainer. This guy.
Is that how that works?
Yeah. Juicery.
You're not even straight
now. Okay. There. And then your garnish. You could do, you know, if you use an orange-based vodka, you do an orange, whatever. There's no really rules for the garnish other than that. The flavor or whatever garnish you're using should make sense for the drink. So that's your Cosmo. You have jiggers.
Okay.
You have limes. Garnishing.
Oh, I remember. Right now I do.
Can we do an experiment where one lady makes it with a Creole Shrub and one lady does it with a triple sec?
I would like to make it with triple sec.
Can we do that?
I'm going to start making a whiskey sour. So whiskey sour. Same principle. It's just different liquor.
Okay.
And clearly it's not working.
Hey.
2 ounces.
Reverend, pay attention, all right?
Simple syrup. My lemon juice, I'll use the larger one there. Lemon in there. Splash of egg whites. My pasteurized egg whites from ShopRite. So this one, I'm going for foamy. It's about egg whites in here. I want this thing nice and frothy and foamy. So really shake it up good. So I just like because they're fun. Instead of a maraschino cherry, but get like a brandy infused cherry or some kind of fun cherry to put in there.
Yes.
Let it sit right on the bottom.
Yeah, that's good. That's good.
Yes. Okay.
Oh,
the
sugar.
Now you messed it up.
That's how you know sugar.
I see froth. I'm feeling very stressed.
I feel the pressure.
I think it was a
bit of margaritas. Here we go.
So what are you making now?
This. Margaritas. These guys.
No, I'm not going to wash this.
The sugar carry, basically.
What that?
It's a sugar caddy.
It's going to give to us how to report the catalog.
This thing travels around forever. It has a sponge on the top level, and then it has two more levels on the bottom.
Oh, cool.
And the idea is... You could add your lime juice here, they just put right on the thing once you go there. You load up lime juice there, so that's going to be the sticky substance. And then you could have salt here, kosher salt, nice big grain salt. And you could have sugar there. And if you're making a daiquiri, frozen daiquiri, you want some colorful sugar on it. Just juice the... Rim.
Is that in our gift bag?
And there she goes. I need a bigger gift bag.
Which one was it making?
This is the margarita. So again, mixing glass, base liquor. This is Chimeo.
You could drink the last bit of it, you had to eat the worm, right?
Right. Somebody says, drink it. So anyway, I'm using a silver tequila. The clear one, they call it silver tequila. There's three kinds. There's silver tequila, there's reposado and añejo. So reposado, the tequila is reserved in a barrel for 6 months to a year, and that's released. So barrel aging just helps smooth out anything. You know, they'll put wines in barrels, they'll put liquors in barrels. In theory, whiskeys and things like that are the color they are because they've sat in a barrel for X number of years. Bourbon is sat in a charred barrel. They literally char the inside of it, so the bourbon's that much deeper. Now they use caramel coloring and stuff like that. So anyway, you want to use silver tequila because when you get into reposado, you're going to make something, put in a barrel for 6 months. That's tying up your money an awfully long time. You want a bigger return. There's more cost. Those barrels are expensive. Mm-hmm. So you're going to pay more money for reposado. And añejo, Spanish word for aged. So that sees at least 1 to 2 years in barrels. So it's more money, but it's smoother. So if you want to sip on a tequila, you want an añejo. Or at the very least, a reposado. If you're going to make a mixed drink, just go with the less expensive silver tequila.
Did I
put
it in the sink?
I'm not afraid of this.
She just called you a show-off.
Hey.
Yay.
So we pass this around since we're a little tight on the plastic cups.